All people believe in existence of time. We often hear that time flows. After Newton, people believed in the force of gravity, though nobody could feel it. During free fall in the vacuum, we experience no force of gravity. Astronauts in space station orbiting the Earth don't feel force of gravity. Einstein proved that for strange behavior of bodies in gravitational field, curvature of space is responsible, not force. The same problem is with time. Time does not flow. So, if time, as most people imagine it, does not exist, what the title of this video suggests, then what is that T in equations describing laws of physics? We should ask, what phenomenon time describes? Time describes phenomenon of change. If there was no change, there wouldn't be such thing as time. We don't experience time. We experience change. We measure time using phenomena that repeat periodically. It means that we measure time by change, and not change by time. Most people believe that time is continuous. It means they believe that change is continuous. The shorter time you want to measure, the more frequent periodical phenomenon that repeats many times during measured change we have to find. At the quantum level, there seem to be limit below which we don't have periodical phenomena. It means that even if time, I mean change, was continuous, at quantum level we couldn't prove it. The existence of speed limit may suggest that the changes are not continuous, and that there is, at microscale level, change during which there cannot be more frequent changes between adjacent places in the universe. We should remember that in universe there is no such thing as speed. It is our way to describe the change. It means that time can't be the parameter describing the smallest scale. At this scale, laws of physics have to describe rules of change, even if it was not continuous. Tunnel effect and changing quantum states by electron in an atom might suggest that change is not continuous. The question rises, if change is only a local event, or change in one place affects the universe as a whole at once. Quantum entanglement suggests that the latter might be the case. We often use term now. It is connected with our belief in existence of time. It means something only locally. What would it mean now in other galaxy? If there was no speed limit, it could mean something, but we know that nothing can move faster than light. So, we have problem with now. Let's assume that we have several perfect clocks here on Earth. We synchronize them. They are in the same place, so it is not a problem. One clock stays on Earth, and the rest are taken to other galaxy, to the same place, but with different paths and different speed. All these clocks would show different hour when they meet in our galaxy. So, if there is 5 o'clock here on Earth, then 5 o'clock on which of the clocks in our galaxy corresponds to our now? Because it is not obvious, we choose one of these clocks synchronized in a way described below. Really, only in our mind those separate events are connected. Even in inertial frame, simultaneity needs definition. We arbitrarily decide which now in our place corresponds to our now. Relativistic relation between the time showed by stationary clock and moving clock is often misunderstood. Time on the moving clock is observed not by one observer, but by two observers at rest relative to each other, whose clocks were synchronized. Time measured by a resting observer is just the difference between times read by those two observers when moving clock was in their place. Clocks are considered synchronized if they show the same time in the moment when beams of light sent from the middle of the line connecting those clocks reach them. This relation describes rate of change in different inertial frames in some way, but it is not that simple as most people think. Time describes change, so it is inner parameter of our universe. Time can't be used to explain why Big Bang occurred. The belief in time leads to absurd questions like, what was before Big Bang? It is as if to ask, what changed before anything existed?